that down the road, you see something down the road coming mm-hmm. that scares you.
Yes.
And when I look down the road here in a scary direction, what I see is Australia.
Yeah.
Which seems to me, and I think we've talked about this before, I don't know, I kind of thought Australia was kind of like us. Like, I thought that Australia was, you know, if you're going to pick five countries in the world that were really similar to us, I probably would name Australia in there. Mm-hmm. The way they're reacting to COVID is, I mean this sincerely, foreign. Like, I don't understand what the government is doing. I don't understand how a lot of the people are reacting very subservient, mm-hmm. it seems to me. Can you walk through, idiot's guide to Australia here for a second? What the heck is going on?
I think the first thing that people need to understand, and what you're saying, so many people have said this to me, they go, Sydney, I thought Australia was just full of these weird convict people that want just, you know, right. like want to play with guns. And no, that's not it at all. So basically, people need to understand first and foremost that America and Australia, while allied, they're more like, I don't know, cousins rather than siblings.
Sure.
So the relationship that you have in the mentality of Australians differs greatly to the United States. The United States, you know, for lack of a better term, used to, I guess, put forward freedom as the primary founding principle of mm-hmm. their belief system. Australia, no, that's not the case. Aussies are very fun-loving, happy, you know, larrikin kind of people. They want to have a laugh. They want to drink their beer and go home to their family. Americans are more like grind, grind, grind. There's a big difference in how they behave. So what we're seeing from the government at the moment comes down to the fact that Australians, and I've said this in so many different shows, they basically value security over freedom. And I think that's a very Commonwealth thing. That's a very Britain thing, mm-hmm. where they basically look to the overarching powers and go, please protect me.
Right.
When in reality, you have to understand that the government is not your friend. And a lot of Aussies, I think, have a distrust. It's bizarre. They have this like inbuilt distrust where they vote out governments when they piss them off. But then nothing ever changes and they go, oh, well, the government told me to do this, so I'll do it. It's this weird contradictory attitude and it drove me insane, which is why I left. I thought this country's never going to change. People are never going to change because they're either apolitical and don't give a damn. They just want to be left alone. Or there are these radical leftists that will, you know, have Black Lives Matter rallies when there's no black people in Australia.
Like, well, that's, I never really thought of that. Yeah.
It's bizarre.
I mean, they still matter, I suppose, but it is an odd title for an organization with a very small African American population.
Or, we don't, in this case, we don't have an African, like the African population is, I think, 0.014% of the population.
Right.
And then you factor in the Aboriginal population, which is like 1%.
Well, it was interesting to see this during COVID, when, because we always told, like, we build these walls and we're mm-hmm. evil and we want to keep everybody out.
Yep.
And like, Australia doesn't want anyone showing up there. Like,
nope.
Now this is just a random theory.
They sequester
theory.
People off to islands.
Yes, off to islands. I thought that was amazing. I think this is a island mindset.
Yeah.
Okay. This is just a theory of mine. Mm-hmm. But like, you notice it with New Zealand, you notice it with Hawaii, you notice it with Australia. When you're an island, you're kind of your own place, mm-hmm. you get very much like, I want zero COVID. I want all the protections in place. No one should come visit us. Mm-hmm. There's some like protectionist weirdness that goes on there. Is that accurate at all?
Yeah. Well, yeah, I think, yes. Yes. I think in large part, yes. Mm-hmm. I think with the COVID stuff, the problem is that the Australian media, you know how American media is kind of super evil?
Yeah.
Australian media is evil, but really dumb.
Okay.
So it's worse because they're like, when you, I'm not even kidding. I want everybody who watches this, I want you to do it too. Go mm-hmm. and watch the news reports that Australia comes out with. And
yeah.
they say, today in the news, there are 5 new COVID cases and this plethora of people are now being institutionalized. And you're like, what?
Wait.
Like, it doesn't make any sense. They're like pumping
these,
this stuff up that's completely negligible. They're making these numbers seem like they matter when they don't. And they're like, the 5 new cases has now locked down the entire Sydney greater area.
Yeah.
And you're like, what? Like, they're saying stories about people going into elevators that are not quarantining, that are not actually sick. They're like, look at this man entering the elevator who has a cough. Now the police are after him. And they make this big deal about it. And you're going, what, like, what did I hit my head and wake up in North Korea? Like, what am I doing here?
Yeah.
Well, and I'm just kidding. North Korea doesn't have any media, so.
That's true. That's true. Or COVID. They have no COVID either.
No COVID either.
Yeah. It's interesting, though, because that really is, watching those reports, and I've seen some of them online.
Bizarre.
It's some of the strangest stuff. It really
Thank
feels
you.
Like it's out of, like, some, you know, Black Mirror episode.
Yeah. It's dystopian. It's bizarre. Because I think the thing is that, again, when you have, so the ABC, a lot of people don't know this, the ABC, the Australian Broadcasting Corporation, they are government funded. They're mm-hmm. taxpayer funded.
Okay.
And they're the
Never
biggest,
a good idea.
Never a good idea.
Never a good idea.
They are the biggest, and they say, they argue that they are the most unbiased, that they're the most, you know, like nonpartisan.
Well, that's just, it goes to how you view the government, right?
For sure.
We would never accept that here, I don't think. I mean, yeah, we do have NPR and PBS, but I think everyone kind of views them as, okay, well, we know this, where this is coming from, or at least what could be influencing it. But the BBC, I don't think Brits see it, the BBC that way.
No.
And that's, I think, a problem, because then you're getting that viewpoint all the time.
Neither do Aussies.